Hi, and you're now with the Forerunner Chronicles. All right, everybody, so if you haven't been watching closely the whole situation that is currently unfolding in Japan, I'm talking about the whole catastrophic nature of the meltdown at Fukushima, then whatever you're doing right now, you need to stop that and take a look at what I'm about to show you because it is absolutely out of control right now. And there may be more to it than what they're telling us on the news. Take a look.
Tokyo has announced plans to dump nearly 12,000 tons of radioactive water from the Fukushima plant.
Is it really as harmless as the government is making out?
Absolutely not. And any other normal circumstances, the release of such volumes of water would be described as catastrophic.
There's no concept how to store the radioactive fuel. The plutonium, if it is ingested by a human body, almost certainly leads to the development of cancer. Plutonium is a very, very dangerous and harmful substance which will radiate for many, many, many thousands of years.
Unsuccessfully trying to restore the cooling system at the facility in what is now the worst atomic crisis since Chernobyl.
The plutonium, if it is ingested by a human body, almost certainly leads to the development of cancer.
Ladies and gentlemen, what I've just shown you is simply a brief synopsis of the horrific horror show that is currently gripping the hearts of every resident that lives within Japan at this time. And now with them dumping tens of thousands of tons of radioactive matter, highly radioactive matter, into the Pacific Ocean, this situation is no longer one that is solely isolated to Japan alone. This situation is getting ready to impact the lives of tens of millions of individuals all throughout the world. People are getting ready to come down with unexplainable, incurable health conditions, and it will be unbeknownst to themselves how this whole thing has come upon them. One day, their health was good. 3 days later, they're laid up in the hospital suffering from some deadly illness, and they will be oblivious as to how their health went south. And the reason why they'll be oblivious is because currently, these individuals have been duped into listening to the peace and safety insidious rhetoric of the politicians and the scientists that are coming on the television set day in and day out feeding us the same thing. There's nothing to worry about. This won't affect the environment. This won't affect your health. How can we listen to such lies and deception? Such nonsense as this. Ladies and gentlemen, life can change in a moment's notice. Just look at what is happening in Japan at this time. This is a first world country we're talking about. One day, they're on the top of the pile. The very next day, they are scrambling feverishly, seeking for a means to stabilize their society, all without warning. But does this mean that the whole situation that is now underway in Japan was not planned? Is it possible that the tsunami that hit Japan, causing catastrophic damage to the Fukushima nuclear plant, was something that was engineered and brought about by a device called HAARP? If you're not familiar with what HAARP is,
HAARP. High Frequency Active Auroral Research Program.
It is a field of antennas on the ground in southeastern Alaska, so linked together as to work as one giant antenna. It's 360 antennas. Each can generate 10,000 watts, 3.6 million watts collectively. The largest legal AM radio station in the US is only 50,000 watts. But they're not broadcasting out. They're broadcasting up.
When HAARP is fired up, all those antennas shoot powerful radio waves into the ionosphere, the uppermost part of the atmosphere. They literally heat it. They create irregularities that allow the ionosphere to bounce powerful radio signals back to Earth.
And when that high-powered beam returns back down to Earth, It not only has the ability to change the weather, and if you thought you didn't hear me right, you heard me right. HAARP has the ability to control the weather. But that high-powered beam that is shot up into the ionosphere by this mechanism also has the power to cause earthquakes. And earthquakes, we know, are the cause behind tsunamis. Now, when this beam is fired off from HAARP, it causes these erratic, radical patterns in the clouds of the sky, like the following images that I'm showing on the screen at this time. Now, I want you to compare those images that I just showed to you with the following video footage, because what I'm about to show you is actual video of Japan's sky just prior to the tsunami that hit on March the 11th, or should I say, on 3/11. Now, after observing that video footage, it's pretty clear to see that the abnormal cloud patterns that were present in the skies above Japan just prior to the tsunami that hit on March the 11th are exactly the same as the peculiar cloud patterns that are produced by the powerful antennas of HAARP. But if that's true, could it also possibly be true that the government of the United States of America is responsible for creating the massive cataclysmic tsunami that hit the shores of Japan, bringing absolute destruction to everything in its path and turning their reality into a living nightmare? Could something like that be possible? How could the government of the United States of America be responsible for perpetrating such a heinous criminal act as this against Japan? I mean, before we start accusing people, there has to be seen a very clear-cut motive as to why this type of evasive action would be carried out. Some extremely clear-cut motives. Do you think it's possible that the government of the United States of America is familiar with the fact that Iran's biggest export is oil? Oil makes up 96% of Iran's exports. And out of that 96% of Iranian oil that is exported, Japan is responsible for importing, for purchasing 12% of that Iranian oil at a whopping $12.7 billion. And those are the old statistics from the year 2007, making Japan one of the largest, if not the largest, importer of Iranian oil. And you know, it takes billions of dollars to develop a feasible nuclear program. A feasible Iranian nuclear program, which the government of the United States of America is dead serious about bringing to an abrupt stop. Do you think our government is familiar with this information that I have just shared with you? Or how about this information? In the February 25th, 2010 publication of the Tehran Times, it is stated that Iran's nuclear program will follow the Japanese model, according to Iranian Representative Ali Larijani. Then, in another notable publication, Japan Today, in June 2010, the Iranian Vice President Ali Akbar Saleh is stated as saying that Iran expects Japan to fulfill its promise of helping it to build nuclear power plants. He also stated that Tokyo was so keen for nuclear cooperation with Iran especially in the construction of new power plants, that it asked Iran not to act hastily in signing contracts with other countries.